Hello, this is Mark Winterbottom from londonappdeveloper.com. In this video, I'm going to explain how you use Android Studio to pull a project from GitHub, otherwise known as cloning a project, how you make changes to that project, commit those changes, and then push them back to GitHub. So I'm going to start off by loading up Android Studio. Here you have the Android Studio welcome screen. And the first thing I'm going to do is choose checkout project from version control. Now, as you can see, I've got lots of different options here. I'm going to choose GitHub, checkout from GitHub, and then I'm going to enter my GitHub credentials, which is my email address and password. I'm going to uncheck save password, but feel free to leave that checked if you're using your own computer. So I've entered my email address and password, and I'm going to click login. Now this is going to access my GitHub account, and it's going to pull down the list of repositories that I have associated with my account. So as you can see here, I have the second one in the list is Hello GitHub, which is a project that I pushed earlier in a previous demonstration in my last video. So I'm going to choose that, and I'm going to change my parent directory because I like to have all of my workspaces in one folder. Update that. I'm going to leave the directory name as default, which is the name of the project. So all this is filled out correctly, and then I'm going to click clone. So this is going to pull down the code from GitHub and store it locally on my machine. As you can see here, it says you have checked out an Android Studio project. Would you like to open it? Yes, we'll open the project in Android Studio now. So the project is loading. You can see Gradle is working in the background to open the project. See two processes running here. So here we can see the code files that I had previously checked into to GitHub. So the first thing we need to do is we need to enable version control on this project. For some reason, Android Studio doesn't by default enable version control when you check out from GitHub. I'm not sure why it doesn't do that, but it's very easy to enable. All you do is click up here, VCS, and enable version control integration. And then it asks you which version control system would you like to use. We're gonna use Git, because GitHub uses Git, and I guess it wouldn't work if you chose any of the other ones. I could be wrong there, but for this tutorial, I'm just gonna choose Git and click OK. So now it's basically set up my project to use Git as a version control. So next I'm going to make a change to the project, which we can then commit and push back to GitHub. So I'm going to make a very small change. All I'm going to do is change this Hello World text to read Hello London App Developer. So the change is made in the strings file here. This is Hello World. We're going to say Hello London App Developer. There we go. So and now we can preview the layout here. You see it's updated, looking very good. And now the next step is to commit these changes to my Git repository so we can then push them to GitHub. So in order to commit them, I'm going to right click Hello GitHub, the project name up here in the top corner. I'm going to choose Git, and I'm going to choose commit directory. So this is basically going to look at all the files that have changed in my Git repository. And you can see here the list of files that's changed. So the strings.xml I changed. VCS.xml updates automatically when you convert the project to a Git project. So that's something that's the system has changed automatically. I'm going to check all the files. And I'm going to write a commit message. This should be something short but descriptive to give other people working on the project and yourself an idea of what you have changed in this commit. So I'm just going to write changed Hello World text to Hello London App Developer. Now it's up to you how specific you want to go with this message, but I like to, every time I write a commit message, write something that somebody else, if someone else works on the project, that they can understand what has changed. So I'm going to leave everything else as default, and I'm going to click commit. So what this is going to do, it's going to commit the changes that I've made to my local Git repository. So nothing's been pushed to GitHub just yet. It's only been stored locally. So the next step is we're going to push the changes that I've just made to GitHub. In order to do that, I'm going to right click Hello GitHub here in the top corner. I'm going to choose Git right at the bottom, and then I'm going to choose a repository, and I'm going to click push. So this is going to bring up the Git push screen, which is basically a confirmation screen highlighting what's changed and what we're going to push. We're going to leave everything as default. This option here is to select to push to an alternative branch. You may want to do that, but for this tutorial, we're just going to push to the master branch. Perhaps in a future video, I'll go into more detail and explain why you may want to change this. But for now, we're going to leave it default, and I'm going to click push. So now it's going to push the changes that I've made. It's going to push them to GitHub. So you can see here it says push successful. Pushed one commit to master. So that's it. Now it's been pushed to GitHub. We can go into our GitHub page here. I'm going to refresh the page. You can see my GitHub repository here, which is the example one. And then you can see here two commits. So if I look here, you can see the comment that I made, which is change hello text to hello London app developer. And you can see that the change was made by me 1 minute ago. So that's it. That's how you make changes and push them to GitHub. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact me using the comments form below this video. Thank you very much. Have a great day.